In this series of figures, we want to look at cardiac histology, or in other words, the microscopic anatomy of cardiac tissue. In the upper left here in panel A, we have a photomicrograph. This is simply a picture taken through a microscope, which allows us to see the subcellular structures. First, we see the presence of striations. Striations are these little stripes found in individual cells that are indicative of the presence of sarcomeres, the contractile units of striated muscle. The sarcomeres are where you find the overlapping thick and thin filaments that allow the generation of tension development. We also see intercalated discs. These are these darker bands. These are found between cells, where cells butt up against one another. It's where we'll find a series of junctional proteins that link these cells together that we'll see in just a moment. We also see individual nuclei for these cells. These cardiac muscle is single nucleated. This is unlike skeletal muscle that has numerous nuclei per cell due to it being formed by cell fusion. Finally, we would also see many, many mitochondria in cardiac muscle. This is a tissue that is adapted to produce significant amounts of ATP aerobically, so the presence of large numbers of mitochondria serve that purpose. In B over here, we have a cartoon version of what we saw in A. It's just, again, pointing out more simplistically the presence of those striations, indicating the presence of the sarcomeres, and then, once again, our intercalated discs where the cells join one another. If we blow that up over here in C, we can now see the presence of the specialized cell-cell junctional proteins forming desmosomes and, at the bottom here, identified gap junctions. These two cell types together, cell-cell junction types together, help form what's termed a functional syncytia. What that means is that these cells work together as a unit through these connections. The desmosomes are a series of proteins that are linked to the cytoskeleton of each cell and then linked to one another in the interstitial space shown here. This allows mechanical force transmission from cell to cell, right? These are contractile cells. They are pulling against one another to develop tension in the walls of the atria or the ventricles to generate pressure. They're pulling against one another to generate that pressure. And so we need to have them well tied together through these desmosomes. The gap junctions, on the other hand, are not a mechanical connection, they're an electrical one, a communication connection. They're formed by a pore in each membrane that docks with the adjacent cell. This connects the cytoplasm of the adjacent cells. So if the cell on the left here were to depolarize due to an influx of cations, we could actually get current flow across the gap junction into this adjacent cell. That would depolarize this cell, leading it to its threshold and opening of voltage-gated channels and generation of an action potential in this cell, and so on and so forth, along a string of cardiomyocytes linked through these gap junctions. Now, once again, the presence of both desmosomes and gap junctions forms a functional syncytia in the atria and again in the ventricles, and that's absolutely essential to those cells working together as a unit, the atria contracting to generate pressure that drives blood flow into the ventricles, and then the ventricles contracting to drive blood flow into the aorta for the systemic circulation or the pulmonary trunk for the pulmonary circulation.